Hello, this is Tony Heller from realclimatescience.com. In this video, I'm going to discuss a couple more propaganda techniques which the press uses to misinform their readers about climate. A few years ago, they started promoting this little girl in pigtails as a climate expert. The United Nations made her a climate spokesperson, and countless newspaper articles have been written about Greta Thunberg. On June 21, 2018, she warned that climate change will wipe out all of humanity unless we stop using fossil fuels over the next 5 years. If she is correct, then today is the last day for the human race. Tomorrow will mark 5 years since she made this dire prediction. Unless you're in New Zealand or Australia, in which case it's already too late. Greta isn't as popular as she used to be, so the New York Times has moved on to using other children to push their agenda. Penguins in your fridge. These 7-year-olds have climate solutions. New Jersey is the first state to require that climate change be taught at all grade levels. Standing in front of her classroom at Slackwood Elementary School north of Trenton, New Jersey one afternoon in June, the teacher asked her first graders to consider a problem. Antarctica is getting warmer. What could the penguins that live there do to adapt? New Jersey has the distinction of being the first and so far only state to require that climate change be taught to all students from kindergarten through 12th grade. The standards are built on a striking premise. Even as storms eat away New Jersey's coastline, snow days become obsolete, and wildfire smoke poisons the air outside, climate change can be taught to the youngest learners without freaking them out. In 1995, the New York Times predicted that most of the beaches on the east coast of the United States would be gone by the year 2020. So according to the New York Times, the beaches in New Jersey are already gone. So why are they scaring children about storms eating away New Jersey's coastline? The New York Times also says snow days become obsolete and wildfire smoke poisons the air outside due to climate change. Those are interesting claims because 6 of the 10 largest snowstorms in New York City have occurred during this century. New York's largest snowstorm occurred in the year 2016. Their second largest snowstorm occurred in 2006. That was the same year which the New York Times announced the endless summer and said polar bears were dying in the Arctic as the sea ice shrinks. There's been no change in Arctic sea ice extent since they made that claim in 2006. There's also no indication that the amount of snow falling in New Jersey has changed over the last 125 years. The New Jersey schools and the New York Times are trying to scare children about Antarctica and the penguins. But satellites show that there's been no trend in Antarctic temperatures over the last 45 years. Antarctica recently experienced their coldest 6 months on record. In 2004, the UK government's chief scientist, Professor Sir David King, said we were all going to have to move to Antarctica because it was going to be too hot everywhere else. In 2008, the Telegraph predicted that climate change was going to cause refugees to flee to incredibly cold Antarctica. They're misinforming children about Antarctica, penguins, Arctic sea ice, polar bears, New Jersey beaches, and snow. They are also misinforming children about wildfire smoke. A couple of weeks ago, when smoke from man-made fires in Canada drifted down into New York, the New York Times, of course, blamed it on climate change. But the northeastern U.S. has a long history of wildfire smoke obscuring the skies. The first time this was recorded to have happened was in 1706, and it's happened every 10 or 20 years since. On June 5, 1903, the northeastern U.S. skies were covered with smoke. This was the result of a long drought and many forest fires. The most famous dark day in the northeastern U.S. occurred on May 19, 1780, during the Revolutionary War. George Washington wrote about this. Everything they're telling the children about climate is misinformation. They're scaring children to push a political agenda. This is not innocent behavior. People with an agenda to shut down our reliable supply of energy are using children in Montana to achieve their goals. 16 Montana children are suing state leaders, saying they've ignored scientific evidence and continued to promote fossil fuels, worsening climate change. They say that violates the right to a clean and healthful environment, which Montana's constitution guarantees. Of course, nobody told these children that their clean, safe, livable environment is due to fossil fuels. Without fossil fuels, these children would be freezing and hungry in the dark. In order to survive, they would have to cut down the forests and burn wood, and the air would be filled with filthy smoke. Very few people lived in Montana prior to the widespread availability of fossil fuels. The climate would have been much too harsh for these pampered school children to survive. On February 16, 1936, Glendive, Montana got down to minus 50 degrees Fahrenheit. And then a few weeks later, on July 5, 1936, they got up to 113 degrees Fahrenheit. Very few of these teachers or children would be living in Montana if they had to survive 160 degree swings in temperature without fossil fuels to keep them alive and comfortable. And it's clear that the children in Montana are not being taught the state's history. 100 years ago, the glaciers in Glacier National Park were melting so quickly that scientists predicted they would all be gone by the year 1950. There was very rapid glacier retreat in Montana from 1850 to 1950, but then the retreat slowed down quite a bit. Google Earth imagery shows that the glaciers in Montana have either remained stable or expanded over the last 30 years. Children in Montana and New Jersey schools have been taught misinformation by people wanting to push an anti-fossil fuels agenda. Now let's look at one more technique used by the press to misinform their readers. This from NPR. Climatologist Judith Curry, who disagrees with the scientific consensus that human activity is primarily responsible for dangerous warming of the planet. There's no evidence that there's a scientific consensus for dangerous warming of the planet. Once again, this is a media creation, which is an attempt to scare people about fossil fuels. Lots of the world's top scientists have been working hard to get the press to stop lying about the dangers of fossil fuels. But NPR has been paid tens of millions of dollars by Bill Gates to push this sort of climate propaganda. This is not a victimless crime. Lots of children are suffering depression as a result of the misinformation they've been taught in school. Greta Thunberg was taught that the world's going to end tomorrow. There's nothing new about the use of innocent children for propaganda purposes. The same technique has been used by evil people over and over again. Vladimir Lenin said, "Give me 4 years to teach the children and the seed I have sown will never be uprooted." I'm going to finish this video up with some footage of the opening ceremony of the 2012 Olympic Games in London. See how many familiar themes you can count from that ceremony 11 years ago.
See some of the great villains of British literature. Literature for children. Cruella de Vil, 101 Dalmatians, Voldemort from Harry Potter, and the Child Catcher from Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. All British.